Good morning. Today's Tuesday. It's the 1st of June. We've been looking at the Word of God a couple of days a week and looking at the promises of God. I want to remind us of Joshua 21 and 45. Not one word of all the good promises that the Lord had made to the house of Israel had failed. All came to pass. And we know the Lord promised many things for Israel, and he kept his promise every time. The Bible's full of promises, promises made to not only Israel, but the people of God and his church and the body of Christ and individuals, you and me. God makes promises to us as well. And we're thankful for the word of Isaiah chapter 55 and verse 11, that God's word will not return void. It will not return empty, but rather it will accomplish all the purposes of God. We're putting our attention on a different subject of God's promises each day. As you know, we've been doing this for, I think, 2 weeks now. And I want to read some promises today regarding mercy, different aspects of our hope in God and his promise, or what his word says about mercy for his people. You've heard the saying that justice is getting or receiving what we deserve. Mercy is not receiving what we deserve, and grace is receiving what we don't deserve. I'm going to talk about mercy and not receiving what we deserve. Let's look at a few scripture verses that speak to the mercy of God. Psalm 103, verse 17 says, "The mercy of the Lord is from everlasting to everlasting on those who fear him, and his righteousness is to sons of sons, to those who keep his covenant, and to those who remember to do his commandments." Exodus 33 and verse 19. "And he said, I will make all my goodness pass before you, and I will proclaim the name of the Lord before you, and I will be gracious to whom I will be gracious, and I will have mercy on whom I will have mercy." Psalm 103 and verse 13 says, "As a father pities his children, the Lord pities those who fear him." Let's go to Hosea. Hosea chapter 2 and verse 23. The Lord says, "And I will sow her to me in the earth, and I will have mercy on no mercy. And I will say to not my people, you are my people, and they shall say, my God." Now that's a little bit of an unusual verse. It may be difficult to get that unless you've read that whole chapter, or you've read Hosea. But let's go back to Hosea chapter 1 and kind of get a little background on this. Gomer conceived, says Hosea chapter 1 and verse 6, "She conceived again and bore a daughter, and God said to him, call her name No Mercy, for I will no more have mercy on the house of Israel, but I will utterly take them away. Verse 7, "But I will have mercy on the house of Judah, and will save them by the Lord their God, and will not save them by bow or sword or battle or horse or by horsemen." Then verse 8, "And when she had weaned no mercy, she conceived and bore a son. And the Lord said, call his name not my people, for you are not my people, and I will not be for you." So let's go back and read Hosea 23 of chapter 2, the next chapter. Again, the Lord says, "I will sow her to me in the earth, and I will have mercy on no mercy. And I will say to not my people, you are my people, and they shall say, my God." I'm thankful for the Lord's mercy. You know, let me give one more passage. I won't read it. Psalm 136. I encourage you to read that. I believe we read that a Sunday or two ago in our morning service, in our prayer time. Psalm 136 and verses 26, there are a total of 26 verses, 26 statements that tell us that God's mercy endures forever. Depending on what Bible translation or version you read, you may read his mercy endures forever, his love endures forever, his loving kindness endures forever, his favor endures forever. Different words are used, but they all mean the same thing, the mercy of God. God is good. God is merciful, and I'm glad for that. Amen. Let's take a moment. Let's pray together and ask the Lord to seal his word to our hearts and our minds, that we would remember and know him. Lord, we thank you for today. We thank you for a new opportunity and not only a new day, but a new month, Lord, on the calendar. We thank you for that. We thank you for a chance to serve you another time. Lord, we're grateful for this word. We're thankful for your mercy. Lord, you've shown mercy. And as our Heavenly Father, you show mercy to your children, and we're grateful for that. Lord, we're so thankful that your mercy is from everlasting to everlasting. Lord, help us as your people to be a faithful people. As you are faithful to us, help us to hear you and obey you and serve you and honor you in every way. Lord, we do lift up your people. We pray for the needs of your people today. Many are suffering. We pray relief and health and strength for them. Lord, if they're facing surgical procedures this week, some are, we ask, Father, your healing hand touch them, those that are in hospital. Lord, encourage them with your presence more than anything. Lord, and then touch them with your healing hand and restore them, everyone. We thank you, Lord, for caring about us, caring about our families, caring about those close to us. Lord, meet our needs, we pray. We thank you for your help. We thank you for your goodness. And Lord, today especially, we thank you for your mercy. I bless your people, Lord, our homes and families. Keep us and guard us, watch over us. Lord, keep your strong hand upon us. In the name of your Son, amen. Well, God bless you today, church. I hope you had a good day yesterday, Memorial Day, and we're thankful for that. We're thankful for all that it means and the great land that we live in and those that have served and given to give us this great land, and we're thankful for that. So I pray you have a great day and a great week, and hopefully we'll see you tomorrow night, Wednesday. We'll have Bible study in the sanctuary with prayer time as well. And we won't have a video tomorrow, but we'll be together if you can make it in the sanctuary. So hopefully we'll look for you and we'll see you then, and pray you have a great day. Take care.